So this heap property is a really useful thing, it's going to turn out. So it's important to figure out how we can take a bunch of numbers and make them satisfy the heap property. So let's do that. Let's start figuring how that will work. First thing to notice is that any one node tree satisfies the heap property because it can't be bigger or smaller than the parent or the child because it doesn't have any parents or childs. So that case is really easy. But now, so let's imagine that we've somehow managed to create two heaps and we'd like to join them together by adding another node and have it the heap property hold. So both of these subtrees, the heap property holds, which means the smallest values in the entire heap are sitting here at the top at the relative roots, but now we're adding a new node. If this node is already smaller than these two, then everything's fine, but it might not be. It might be that this is a large value. So let's give an example. So what do we do at this point? We need the heap property to hold everywhere for this to actually be a heap. So what can we do? Well, so with respect to these three nodes, we're going to need to change something to establish the heap property, at least locally. So first thing we're going to do is we're going to do some swapping around. Which value can we swap to the top to move things in the direction of more establishing the heap property? So which of these values should be at the root here? Write the answer in the box.